Hello, future League of Agents players. Thank you for taking time to watch this brief video. We are currently in the middle of the NFT pre-sale, which gives you possibility to buy skins before the project starts. The popularity of the NFT skin pre-sales proves the big potential this game has. Today, I need to inform you about some less favorable circumstances regarding this project, and I want to tell you what actions League of Agents takes to make sure we got served on the best way possible. That's why I want to explain to you what's going on behind the scenes and why this might be a positive sign for the project. Okay, I'll start with a bit of explanation about the funding of a project such as League of Agents. There is a big team needed of a lot of professionals in several areas to make sure the developments will proceed in the best way possible. League of Agents has a great team and is working very hard for months to accomplish great things. Therefore, they need funding to make sure the users have a great gaming experience. Employees need to get paid, they need to invest in infrastructure, and also marketing is quite important to make a project succeed. League of Agents has had a private and public sale of both tokens and NFTs. We are able to participate in the public pre-sales, but there are also venture capitalists who invest a relative large sum of money in the project. They serve as a strategic partner to guide the project towards a great success, since they will also benefit from the success of the project. Now, the following challenge has come up. So there is one private investor that invested a certain amount in the pre-sale. So this guy therefore receives a certain amount of tokens. But he now tries to obtain a substantial amount of LOA tokens, or he will start legally attacking the project. League of Agents has decided they won't give him the tokens because this won't favor the project. When a single entity has a big amount of the tokens, the project loses the decentralization because the entity has a big control over the project. And we as the users want a decentralized project instead of a single entity decide what's going to happen with the project. That's the whole point of blockchain gaming. Because the team of League of Agents wants the best for all users, it can't admit to the threats. As an attack on the project, he starts to spread fear, uncertainty and doubt. Because private investors are mostly well-capitalized entities, they often have some influence. Therefore, they can release negative news about the project and spreading FUD. That's why I want to make clear that League of Agents isn't doing anything illegal. They are working day in, day out to make a great project for us. We can't go down because some well-capitalized bully is using his power to serve his own interest and blackmailing the team. It truly is a great choice that they didn't give in to his threats. This shows that the community is way too important for League of Agents and they will do anything to serve us well. Please keep in mind, when you see any FUD about the project, it will likely be the venture capitalist trying to destroy the project. I also think he understands the big potential of the project and therefore wants a bigger share of the pie. This once again proves that League of Agents will be a huge project. Finally, we can make money while playing our favorite game. Thanks for watching, and I'll promise to keep you updated.